Do not give Linzess to children less than 2 years old. It may harm them. Do not take Linzess if you have a bowel blockage. Get immediate help if you develop unusual or severe stomach pain, especially with bloody or black stools. The most common side effect is diarrhea, sometimes severe. If it's severe, stop taking Linzess and call your doctor right away. Other side effects include gas.
A lot of your first stores, especially around here, they're starting to get Christmas stuff out, so now is the time to look for it, and it's everywhere. So, people right now, other shoppers are not looking for Christmas. So, it's the time to find the good stuff, because people aren't looking for it at all. I will show you. Hang on one second before I go over there. I'd like to tell you about Steve. He's a plumber. I hear he does good work. Also, oh, God, you're so much. If I could be a upholsterer, I would get that.
She has a new vegan restaurant. I don't even know that was a thing yet.
Anyway,
so
cool.
If you need those things,
just wander
around and try to find them. For a local customer analysis, where you can see how many local customers in Cedar Rapids, Waterloo, you can reach online. What are those? Those were... looks like that they're brass. Are those to hold stockings? Another good thing to look for when you're in thrift stores and looking through the wrapping paper. Hang on. Looking through the Christmas decor is to look through the wrapping paper. Because you can find some vintage wrapping. This thing is so heavy. What is this thing? It's really pretty, but oh my gosh, it's like I can't lift it with one arm. Look through the wrapping paper because you can find some vintage wrapping paper that's really cool. It looks really cool underneath the tree. I'm always looking for pine cones, but there's some huge ones in that bag. And then always look through that little car is cute. Always look through the bags of ornaments. Even if you only found like one thing in there. This is really pretty. Wow. Isn't that pretty? Most thrift stores, not all, will just throw in the ornaments into one. They won't pay attention, but okay, when I was in here, there was a lady just standing right here, so I didn't get to look that well.
it's really pretty. But look at all this Christmas stuff. Like, I'm trying not to make you dizzy, but it's all the way down. So, and you really do, you have to kind of really dig, like in bags like this for vintage ribbons. Look at all the brass bells in there. This is all bells in here. And this is where you find vintage Santa mugs. People aren't thinking Christmas right now, so it's kind of, it's great. I just shove things in here. Love these. I've showed these many times. They're starting to love them too. I like to spend under $1 for them that don't have the plastic like from the dollar stores. Just look cute with candies and stuff in it at Christmas time. And to have just different sizes of them lined up. He kind of looks like a vintage Santa back there. I would love to see if you find any vintage Christmas items in your thrift stores. If you do, share a photo, tag me on Instagram at My Creative Days. I would love to see what you guys are finding out there. What is this? Oh, let's see, like just the pictures in here. Well, maybe not. I thought there would be some more. Christmas in July. By the time this comes out, it'll probably be August though. These vintage tins are cool too. Like this one. Speckled eggs, I love. If this was cheap enough, it's $4.99. It's cute as it is, but I would buy that for just the eggs alone, and I will show you. Sorry. Like this wreath is full of them, and this is only $2.99, so that's a steal, and I would take all of these off and just use the eggs like in a bowl.
Thank you.
all you need to look for in this kind of area. I really love the pottery look, and I've shared videos on my YouTube channel for how to get an authentic pottery look for a lot less, and this is where you go. You find pieces that have the shape. This is like wood, lightweight, and then you do the paint technique that I shared, and they look like authentic pottery pieces. There's another good candidate. This is a good candidate too. I just don't love these things on there. But definitely, this is the section you come to. Like, this one's good, and you could even cover up that, like these grapes or whatever they are, with the paint. But this is a really good candidate too. Oh my gosh, that's super heavy too. That's pretty. I love these. I just think they're the cutest things. They're so cute. If they have the balls, I've never seen them. You can't really tell, but the mallets are really wide. If they have the balls, I would probably get that. And as always, check the tops of these areas. This is kids' clothes, so I'm not looking in here, but I just found a bag of vintage ornaments up here in the clothes. So always check the tops of racks if you've got those at your local thrift stores. Okay, so I'm back, and I thought I'd just share my little haul with you guys and show you what I actually did pick up. It started getting busy in there, and so the air wasn't moving so great in there. So another tip I wanted to share with you is always check your thrift stores if they have sales. So different stores do it different ways, but a lot of our thrift stores, the color of the tag, they will have sales on, like green and yellow tags are half off, or all books are half off, or all furniture is half off, whatever. Just make sure when you're shopping in the stores, find out if they have a sale for the day, the week. It's always a good thing to do as soon as you get inside the store. So I will always pick up these brass horns for Christmas. Like I said, they have a lot of Christmas stuff out now. And their sign, as I left, I saw it on the outside. It says Christmas in July. So it's a good way for them to kind of push some of the Christmas stuff they already have. So I grabbed those. You can do so much with these. My mom used to decorate with these, I remember. So I always grab these when I find them. And these are large. So these will likely end up in my shop. I do sell some of my vintage finds on my shop page, which we will leave a link to that in the description of this video. But so I grabbed those. And then if you have followed my creative days and me for a while on any platform, I love to find the old or just Scrabble games at thrift stores and estate sales and yard sales for inexpensive, because I love to put the wood tiles in vases and bowls and jars, and I just love the way they look. I have made Christmas ornaments out of, the wood blocks, and then I will spell, Christmas words on there, and then you just put a little hook on the here, and then you can hang them on your tree. I've also made them as name tags for gifts for Christmas. So, grandma, I would put here and then do the same thing and kind of tie it on the gift. So, but I pick them up mostly. I haven't done the ornaments in those in a long, long time. I pick them up mostly just to fill jars and things inside our home. I just love the way they look. Then I grabbed these. They're Hawking. What is it? I'm going to forget the name, but I just love these whenever I find them. And I finally found there were 5 of these. So I grabbed them. I've grabbed them. But when they're stacked like this, they look like a Christmas tree to me. So if you put a light, like a little tea light or a little string of those, like the battery operated light underneath the bottom one, I wonder what that would look like. It needs to be a little bit taller, but it kind of looks like a Christmas tree all piled up like this. But I just love the little balls kind of at the bottom. I don't know. I just think they're really cute. So I grabbed those.
Then I grabbed this. It is a bread knife, and these aren't that cheap, and this is a brand new one. So things like this, I actually found another one at a different thrift store, again, brand new. But to get either bake a loaf of sour bread or to go to a bread store or a local bakery and get some sourdough bread, and then gift this along with somebody, a new neighbor, or just like a welcome home gift or something, I think that would be a good gift. So I had to grab this just because it was such a good deal. It's brand new. I don't know if I will do that, but I thought, oh, that would make a great gift. Okay, and then when I was inside the store, I told you guys, check the bags and look at these ornaments. I would love to find out where they're from, but these are ornaments. I just absolutely look at this bird. They are, I mean, they're a good weight. They are just so, and then there's one more in here. Look at these. I don't know. I just fell in love with them. I think they're so pretty. And then there's just a random flamingo in the bag as well. But I got it for these. They are just so pretty. And then I found this bag. And for Christmas, always look in these bags because you will find vintage ornaments. Look at these. Look at this one. Oops. There are vintage ornaments in this bag. So I grabbed this quickly, and it was up on top of the kids' clothes, up on the stuff, or up in the shelves by the kids' clothes. So look at these. So that was a good buy. I'm excited to kind of pull everything out of there and really look at that. So that's all I got. Not a huge haul, but yet some fun things. So if you find these thrifting trips and tips and hauls helpful, share this video. Make sure you subscribe, and I will keep posting more of these videos for you guys.